co-author of How to Draw Comics the Marvel Way, and creator of Spider-Man, The Incredible Hulk, and a whole caboodle of other comic book characters that my legendary modesty prevents me from mentioning. Now, I'll be your host and guide as we journey together along the rambunctious road to comic book artistry, which is to say, it looks like we're stuck with each other for the next little while. Now then, let's start with the basics. And what can be more basic than having an artist teach us how to draw? Certainly better than a plumber. And what artist can be better suited to this titanic task than my co-author and good buddy, none other than John Buscema? Thank you. Now let's draw a comic. The Marvel Way.
First thing you'll need is a drawing chair. It could be a table like this one, or even a flat board, place on your lap. So, next you'll need some drawing paper. Marvel Odyssey 2x Bristol board, wide enough to accommodate artwork 10 by 15 inches. You'll also need push pins to keep your paper from slipping off the board, thumbtacks for a solo tape.
Of course, you'll need a pencil. You didn't think it would be so complicated, did you? Now, some artists prefer a soft lead pencil, like the one John is using. Others, of a more delicate pencil, select a finer hard lead, like this one here. There are many different pencil grades available. Which one you choose is up to you, of course.
Most professionals use an eraser like this. It's called kneaded eraser.
But since Marvelites hardly ever make mistakes, let's move on. You'll need a simple drawing pen with a thin point for inking and bordering. A brush is a must. Your best bet is a Sable Hair, number 3. You'll also need a bottle of black India ink, of course. Any good brand will do.
These brushes are very expensive. If you don't know how to clean them, you can ruin them. What you do is swirl them around the water, rub it up against the glass jar, and gently rub it along the sides of it. Come to a fine point.
And let's not forget a supply of white opaquing paint to cover those rare mistakes we make from time to time. That's better. Your T-square is an invaluable tool for drawing borders and for keeping lines parallel. A triangle, too, is a necessity for drawing right angles and working in perspective. And don't forget an ink compass for drawing perfect circles. Plus, you might as well get a pencil compass, too. Any or all of these tools of the trade are available at your favorite art supply store. Now, just to make sure we're using the same language when we refer to things, let's review the various names for many of the elements that make up a typical comic book page. The first page of a story with a large introductory illustration is called the splash page. Letters drawn in outline with space for color to be added are called open letters. Copy which relates to a title is called a blurb. The name of the story is naturally called the title. An outline around the lettering done in this jagged shape is called a splash balloon. A single illustration on a page is called a panel. The space between panels is called the gutter. And I'm sure you won't be surprised to learn that this sack is called a sound effect. Copy which represents what a character is thinking is, logically enough, a thought balloon. The little connecting circles on the thought balloons are called bubbles. I mean, we feel silly calling them squares. The regular features of the leaf are the all-important dialogue balloons. The connecting arrows on the dialogue balloon showing who is speaking are called pointers. The words in the balloons which are lettered are referred to as pointers or bold lettering. And this is my favorite part where the names are. We call it the credits, just like in the movies. All this technical stuff, which nobody ever reads, showing who publishes the mag.
Hulk smash. Hulk swung of the years.
Is the adhesion. Don't blame me, I didn't make up that word.